Dear fellow scholars, this is 2-Minute Papers with Károly Zsolnai Fehér. Not so long ago, we talked about a technique that enabled us to render stunningly high-quality cloth models in real time. It supported level of detail, self-shadowing, and lots of other goodies that make computer game developers, and of course, my humble self, super happy. And today, we are going to talk about a technique that is able to create these highly detailed cloth geometries for our digital characters. I have really fond memories of attending to the talk of the Oscar Award winner Steve Marschner on this paper a few years ago in Switzerland, and I remember being so spellbound by it that I knew this was a day I will never forget. I am sure you'll love it too. In this piece of work, the goal is to create a digital garment model that is as detailed and realistic as possible. We start out with an input 3D geometry that shows the rough shape of the model. Then, we pick a knitting pattern of our choice. After that, the points of this knitting pattern are moved so that they correctly fit this 3D geometry that we specified. And now comes the coolest part. What we created so far is an ad hoc model that doesn't really look and behave like a real piece of cloth. To remedy this, a physics-based simulation is run that takes this ad hoc model, and the output of this process will be a realistic rest shape for these yarn curves. And here you can witness how the simulated forces pull the entire piece of garment together. We start out with dreaming up a piece of cloth geometry, and this simulator gradually transforms it into a real-world version of that. This is a step that we call yarn level relaxation. Wow! These final results look not only magnificent, but in a physical simulation they also behave like real garments. It's such a joy to look at results like this. Loving it! Again, I would like to note that we are not talking about the visualization of the garment, but creating a realistic piece of geometry. The most obvious drawback of this technique is its computation time. It was run on a very expensive system and still took several hours of number crunching to get this done. However, I haven't seen an implementation of this on the graphics card yet, so if someone can come up with an efficient way to do it, in an ideal case, we may be able to do this in several minutes. I also have to notify you about the fact that it is considered a crime not having a look at the paper in the video description. It does not suffice to say that it is well written. It is so brilliantly presented, it's truly a one-of-a-kind work that everyone has to see. If you enjoyed this episode, make sure to subscribe to 2-Minute Papers, we'd be happy to have you in our growing club of fellow scholars. Thanks for watching and for your generous support, and I'll see you next time.